Welcome to Introduction to Matrices. The goals of this video are to define a matrix, identify the dimensions of a matrix, identify elements in a matrix, and also to perform matrix addition, subtraction, and scalar multiplication. A matrix is a rectangular arrangement or array of numbers that are often called elements. Here are four examples of matrices. Notice that usually capital letters represent a matrix, and the arrangement of numbers are enclosed in square brackets as we see here. Each matrix has a dimension, and the dimension m by n of a matrix identifies how many rows and columns a specific matrix has. The number of rows is m, and the number of columns is n. And that's important because this first number here will be rows, and the second number here will be columns. So if we take a look at matrix A, rows go from left to right, so this matrix has 1, 2, 3 rows. So if we count down, we can see we'd have 3 rows. And this matrix has 2 columns, 1, 2. So this is a 3x2 matrix. 3 rows and 2 columns. If we take a look at matrix B, this has 1, 2 rows and 1, 2, 3 columns. Therefore, this is a 2x3 matrix. So here you can see why it's so important that the rows come first and the columns are second, because a 3x2 is quite different than a 2x3 matrix. Matrix C has 1 row and 1, 2, 3 columns. Therefore, it's a 1x3 matrix, sometimes called a row matrix because it has a single row. And matrix D has 1, 2 rows and 1 column. Therefore, it is a 2x1 matrix. And this can also be called a column matrix. So once again, if we're looking at any matrix, if we count down, we'll be counting the number of rows. And if we count across, we'll be counting the number of columns, as we see here. And let me go ahead and clear this highlighting. Since each element in a matrix has a unique location based upon its row and column, we can identify the location of a specific element using this notation here, where the first number would be the row and the second number would be the column. So this element here is in row 3, column 1. This element here is in row 2, column 3, and so on. Now sometimes you'll see commas in between the row and column, and sometimes you won't. It just depends on the textbook. So if we want to identify these four elements in this matrix, looking at A sub 2, 3, this represents the number in row 2, column 3 of matrix A. So here's row 1, here's row 2, column 1, 2, 3. So A sub 2, 3 is equal to 5. A sub 3, 2 would be the element in row 3, column 2. So here's row 1, row 2, row 3, and then column 1, column 2. So A sub 3, 2 is equal to 4. A sub 1, 2 would be the element in row 1, column 2. Here's row 1, column 1, column 2. So this is equal to 2. And then lastly, A sub 4, 2 would be the element in row 4, column 2. And notice that this matrix does not have a row 4. Therefore, this element is not in the matrix. Now let's talk about how we can add and subtract matrices. The first thing we need to be aware of is that the sum of two matrices can only be found if both matrices have the same dimension. If they don't have the same dimension, they cannot be added or subtracted. So once we know that two matrices have the same dimension, to determine the sum, we just add the corresponding elements. And similarly, when we want to find the difference of two matrices, as long as they have the same dimension, to find the difference, we'll just subtract the corresponding elements. So let's go ahead and take a look at a couple of examples. For number 1, we want to sum matrix A and matrix B, but matrix A is a 2x2 matrix, 2 rows and 2 columns, and matrix B is a 2x3 matrix. These don't have the same dimension, therefore we cannot determine this sum. For number two, we want the sum of matrix A and matrix C. Well, matrix C is also a 2x2, so we can find the sum. Let's go ahead and write this out. So the result will have the same dimension, and now we just add the corresponding elements, or the elements in the same positions. So we'll have 4 plus negative 3, that would be 1, 7 plus negative 7, that's 0, and 2 plus 5, that would be 7, and negative 1 plus 6 is equal to 5. So as you can see, it's pretty straightforward. For number 3, we want matrix C minus matrix A. Again, they have the same dimensions. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll have matrix C minus matrix A. Of course, when we're subtracting, we do have to be careful of our signs. So for row 1, column 1, we'll have negative 3 minus positive 4. That's going to be negative 7. In row 1, column 2, we'll have negative 7 minus 7. That's negative 14. For row 2, column 1, we have 5 minus 2. Is 3, and row 2, column 2, we have 6 minus negative 1, which becomes 6 plus 1, so we have 7. Let's talk about scalar multiplication now. This is going to remind you of distribution, which you learned in your first algebra class. The product of a scalar or real number and a matrix is equal to the scalar times each element in the matrix. So if this is matrix B, and we want 5 times B, this represents scalar multiplication. So we would have 5 times matrix B. So we're going to multiply each element or each number in this matrix by 5. The dimension will stay the same. So for row 1, column 1, we'll have 5 times negative 1, that's negative 5. For row 1, column 2, we'll have 5 times 2, that's 10. And then row 1, column 3, 5 times 8 would be 40. And so on. 5 times negative 3, 5 times negative 7, and 5 times 1. And that's it for scalar multiplication. Let's go and take a look at one more example. Sometimes you will be asked to determine a sum or difference of two matrices combined with scalar multiplication. So on number 1, we want 4 times matrix B plus 2 times matrix D. Let's first check the dimensions of these two matrices. Matrix B would be 2 rows by 1 column, and matrix D is also 2 rows by 1 column. So we can go ahead and find this sum. Let's go ahead and write it out. We're going to have 4 times matrix B plus 2 times matrix D. Let's go ahead and apply the scalar multiplication first. So we'll have 16 and 28 plus 0 and negative 6. So the final sum will be 16 plus 0, that's 16. 28 plus negative 6 will give us 22. And number 2, we have matrix C minus 3 times matrix A. Both matrix C and A are 2 by 2 matrices, so we can go ahead and find this difference. Let's go ahead and write matrix C minus 3 times matrix A, which is 4, 7, 2, negative 1. First we'll perform the scalar multiplication and then we'll subtract. So we're going to have 12, 21, 6, and negative 3. Now notice I multiplied by a positive 3 and kept it as a difference. Now we'll go ahead and subtract corresponding elements. Negative 3 minus 12, negative 15. Negative 7 minus 21, that's negative 28. 5 minus 6, negative 1. And 6 minus negative 3 becomes 6 plus 3, or 9. Okay, that'll do it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. Thank you for watching.